When most people talk about finding the average of a set of numbers, they're usually talking about the arithmetic mean, and that's done easily, both manually and within an Excel formula. But what about those times when you want to find the average of a set of numbers where some numbers carry more weight than others? Maybe you've heard this before. Your coursework will be 10% of your final grade, the quiz is worth 30%, and your exams are 60%. What this means is if you get 100% on your coursework, then you've secured 10% of your final grade. 100% on your quiz, and you've secured 30%, and so on. We can do this manually by multiplying the weight of each score that we got, and then getting the total. This is how we do this manually. But there's an Excel function that can do that. It's called the sum product. And here's how it works. We type sum product, select our first array and our second array, close parentheses, hit enter. And we have the same result. Now, sometimes we take it for granted that our weights will always add up to 100%, like in our previous example. But what about maybe a project management scenario where the weights are priorities and not percentages? Maybe for this company, we have 9 tasks that we'd like to complete, but they have different degrees of importance. So we've assigned priorities and we're doing a mid-month check-in with each department. Each department has submitted their update for their tasks, and we want an overall figure for our company's task completion status. These are our priorities from 1 to 9, not listed in order, and when our weights don't add up to 100%, we have to remember to divide by the sum of the priorities assigned to our tasks. So we can still use the sum product function. We have our first array, our second array, close parentheses, but now, because column B does not add up to 100%, we have to remember to divide by the values here. And this is a percentage. So how complete are our projects overall? We're at 68%. Sometimes it's preferable to see the average of a set of numbers as a trend rather than a single figure. Moving averages are a good way to establish a trend over time while smoothing out the effect of fluctuations. The most convenient way to get Excel to calculate a moving average is to enable the Data Analysis Toolpack on the ribbon. First, check on your Data tab to see if it's already there. If it is, it'll show up on the Analysis Command Group. If it isn't, click on the File tab, look for Options, then Add-ins. Select Excel Add-ins from the drop-down menu and click Go. Check the Analysis Toolpack option, then click OK. Now we're ready to use it from the ribbon. First, let's take a look at our data. Here we have 10 years of sales history. To smooth out the peaks and lows caused by the years 2012, 2016, and 2018, we can use a moving average. Instead of relying on a single average of 101,000, the moving average establishes a trend by using the average of a set of intervals. To get started, we click on the Data Analysis command, select Moving Average, and click OK. From the Moving Average window, enter the input range. That's the range we'll be using to calculate our averages. That'll be the values in this column. If your range selection included labels in the first row, check this box. We didn't select labels in the first row, so we'll leave this box unchecked. How many intervals will we be using to calculate our moving average? It's good to remember that the larger the interval, the fewer spikes and troughs you'll see in your output data. Let's use 5. So Excel will use 5 years at a time to calculate the moving average figures. In the output range field, enter the cell where you'd like to see your data showing up. We want it to show up here. If we also want Excel to create a line chart which compares our source data with the output data, check this box. And to see the standard deviation, we check this box. We don't need to see that in this example, so we won't. We click OK. And here's our output. Excel creates a data table starting at cell C4 as requested, but we notice that our output data doesn't actually start until here, C8. This is because Excel needs 5 pieces of data to calculate the 5 interval average we asked for. What the moving average tool did was to create a formula within each cell calculating the average of the last 5 years from column B. So in interpreting this, we'd say that for the first 5 years, we averaged $96,000 in sales. Between 2011 and 2015, we averaged $97,000, and so on. Looking at the line graph, let's expand. We can see that point 10 represents the most recent year, and data point number 1 was our first year. Overall, the orange line shows that there was an upward trend, despite there being some years with very high or very low numbers. Of course, if you don't have the data analysis add-in, you can calculate the moving average on your own by getting the average of the number of intervals that you feel makes your data more accurate or relevant. Just remember to use relative cell references instead of absolute so that your formula moves when you copy it to adjacent cells. Want to learn more Excel tools and features? Check out our other resources at GoSkills.com.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.